beings. What I have in mind is, I should not let you think about, so that you will not have any prejudice mind when you actually listen. 2 years back, I was actually doing a workshop on communication, and I asked the audience this question: what is the most important thing that you do in your everyday life? And I was actually expecting the answer that is communication, but unfortunately one person stood up and said eating, sleeping, and some college students, they said Facebook and WhatsApp. So in the, you know, in the, I forgot your name, Anish. Your name, no? Yes. Yes, Ajaz was actually talking about the elephant. So as trainers in the movie, Mukesh was actually expecting that, you know, when you see the elephant, you're supposed to run. But what actually happened, one student said, no, I will throw stones at the elephant, then it creates a problem. So suppose we trainers will have to face this problem. We expect the audience to give an answer, and sometimes we will not get that particular answer. So we will have that problem. So what I'm trying to stop is connecting with the audience. The main purpose of our communication is actually connecting with. What I understand is we have to first search for the convenience of our audience. Bridget sir was actually talking about, you know, when you finish the training at 5:30, where the college bus leaves at 4:30, then we are actually in a deep trouble. We trainers do have a big problem, that is, we assume everyone else is actually in their comfort zone, right or wrong, and we keep telling them, come out of your comfort zone. That is a comfort zone syndrome that is associated with the trainers. But what I feel is we have to actually place them back in their comfort zone. Think about this. A child or a student who gets up early in the morning, 6 o'clock, goes to tuition, he has got other activities, then he goes to school, colleges, after that he has the evening class, violin, sports, all those things. Has he been in his comfort zone? And if you're asking him to come out of the comfort zone, the question he might ask is, I have never been in my comfort zone. And if you have to really connect with some person, what we have to do is to, we have to really place them back in their comfort zone. Asking them to come out of the comfort zone is like asking the, you know, telling the fish, now you have done enough of swimming, come out of the, you know, come out of the water, now try showing your skills in the dry land. We can't ask the fish to do that. So that is an area. And I just want to stop with this. I'm working as a skill development executive of ASAP at Rajiv Gandhi Residential Memorial Higher Secondary School. And that is purely tribal students, all tribal students. It's a residential school. So the classes actually gets over at 4:30. And I found that these students are very hyperactive students and they really want to play football. So 4:30 to 6 o'clock, that is actually the time to play. And I found that. And I could see the boys, you know, coming to class with a very tough mind, with difficult mind. So I asked them this question. I'm happy to allow you to play football, but I want to complete this course. How can you help me? And they gave me, sir, can you take class from 6 to 8? 6 to 8. Believe me, the attendance level, 35 students were there. The average attendance level for some period, it was 22, and it directly shooted up to 35. What I did was, I just asked them, what is your convenience? Because always, when you really start to ask for others' convenience, that is the best way we can connect with all the people who is actually listening to. So thank you for giving the opportunity, and I'm very happy to be here. Thank you.